and welcome to a movie review. I'm the Bulk, and today I'll be talking about Baywatch.
Our team is the elite of the elite. We're the heart and soul of this very beach. We protect when other people don't want to protect. And we go above and beyond.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, and a brief warning, there are going to be some spoilers, because there's some things in this film that I have to talk about. The film is directed by Seth Gordon, and follows Mitch, a lifeguard and leader of the Baywatch program. He's very well known and respected amongst the community for having saved over 500 people from near-death experiences on the beach. Now, his sense of fun and entertainment is disrupted slightly by the arrival of former Olympic swimmer Matt Brody, played by Zac Efron, who arrives and immediately wants to become part of the team, believing that his celebrity status should immediately entitle him to become part of said team. Now, my problems with the film, well, as always, Dwayne Johnson is fun and lovable to watch. You can get behind him, he's very energetic and has a very good screen presence. The same can't really be said, though, for Zac Efron. He comes across as flat, his character motivations are very mixed up, he doesn't really get developed much, his character's not overly too interesting, and that can come across as a dick. The little bit of backstory we have for him, again, itself is just not interesting, and if anything, quite disgusting. Because, you see, he was an Olympic gold medal champion, won two gold medals, but then when it came to doing an Olympic relay race, he got drunk the night before, and so when he came to swim the race, he jumped into the pool and vomited, giving him the nickname the Vomit Comet. Which, of course, it's just not really that interesting of a motivation. You can't really get behind the character. It's fun enough and has a nice enough personality, but you just can't really feel for him because he's too much of a dick to everyone else, making, like, sexual advances towards a lot of the female characters, and he comes across as a very forced character. You can tell that the writing for him wasn't as on point as it should be. On the plus side, there is an interesting relation dynamic between two other characters. This fat kid who hangs around with them called Ronnie. He's got a crush on a hot girl called CJ. Now, instead, you think, oh, with this type of relationship dynamic, they're going to go for the stereotypical, he's awkward around her, but he likes her, but she doesn't think of anything of him. However, they completely go against this idea in its entirety, and it says she actually does have feelings for him, and actually does, like, look at him in that way, and actually does feel for him. It's just, even then, they're still awkward together, and of course they don't get together till the very end of the film, but when it happens, you feel satisfied yourself, because you feel like they're the two people that actually deserve to be together. Ronnie himself is actually quite funny, though there's one joke of his that I'll get onto in a minute that completely ruins my believability in the film, well, what little believability there is in this film. In terms of plot, the villain of the piece, Victoria Leeds, played by Priyanka Chopra, is completely uninteresting. She's your stereotypical drug-dealing, scheming woman villain character who is well-performed, I must say, but just hasn't really got a presence. And every time she comes into the film, she brings it to a screeching halt and completely changes the tone. Also, there's this horrid, horrid thing I found of her, that they seem to have wrote her in such a way that every time she's being intimidating towards a character, she says something like, oh, you wouldn't say that if I was a woman, a man, you wouldn't think that way if I was a man, oh, my brother got this because he was a man. She says all these type of things, and it really hits you over the head with the idea that, oh, we're not sexist. Like, the film is blatantly trying to say to you, we're not sexist, which leads me on to one of the biggest problems of the film, is that it's got very, very blunt themes. Every minority group that you could possibly imagine is given some sort of beefing up in this area. They have a black cop where Mitch, Dwayne's character, makes a comment that, oh, you can't say certain things, or you can't make certain things, like, oh, you people, you can't say that type of thing around him. They have a big point about not sexualizing the women, which comes off completely awful, because if you're a fan of Baywatch, you're going to know that a lot of people watched it in the originally because it was one of the few television programs that showed sexually suggestive content at prime time. Now, the problem here is people nowadays have moved on. Sexuality is not that vibrant in the media anymore. And of course, you have the problem of people causing of sexism. So in order to counteract that, they've included a lot of references to male genitalia and penises and stuff like that. And the thing is, it's not that as a guy, I have a problem with that, because I understand, oh, that's what you're trying to do. But the thing is, it becomes a problem when you're forcing it down our throats every 5 minutes, that, oh, we're not sexist and so forth. And even having one scene where I literally have to sit there and witness Zac Efron fondling a dead man's balls. Nah, they're not going to show it. They're not going to show it. Oh, trust me. You see the whole meat and two veg just sat right there. Not even out of shot. The whole schlong just sat there and in prime view for some god-awful, inconspicuous reason that I cannot even pinpoint. Another big problem with the film happens to be that the tone just does not work. You have this comedic sort of piss-take type tone with the film, for the majority of it. But then you have this bit where they're actually realising, oh crap, we need to have an actual plot. And they don't bloody do it. You spend all this time trying to get invested in the characters and this little plot, but essentially the main plot becomes a side plot, and all the little character motivations become main focus, which completely disrupts the actual tone of the film, because you have these, like, trying to be really dark and serious scenes with the villain, and they're just off-kilted by Dwayne Johnson popping a swear every 5 minutes. And there's one scene, this one awfully executed scene where they felt that it was necessary to have a boat on fire on water, which is possible, that can happen, I'll give them that. But the fire looks like something you would see from a Game Boy game. It is really crap CGI. It's not just a bit of fire, it's loads of bloody fire. It's like bloody Hell's Inferno on sea on a boat. You just got Dwayne Johnson climbing around this burning boat with screaming bikini clad women covered in drugs. For a film of today's age, you cannot have an excuse for bad CGI. Must say, there are a few bits I actually did like in the film, specifically a few scenes. This is where the spoilers kick in. Please be warned that there are heavy spoilers in the next few minutes. I am putting a little sign in the corner of the video to say there are spoilers. Once you see this little sign disappear, you're safe. So yes, undoubtedly my favourite part of this 2-hour movie has to be when the main villain, Victoria, gets killed. For action films, it's a stereotype that the main character will deliver a little quip before he kills her. In this film, they decided to give Dwayne Johnson a blinking monologue about his connection with the sea. Now you think, oh no, it'll be some weird cheesy thing. Oh god no, it's a bloody poem in a sense. He goes along the lines of saying, I scratch my back with coral, I piss seawater, and this is an actual quote right now, I rub myself with Poseidon's ball sack. No, that is not even a joke, that is even in the film. No, I will give the film credit where it's due. It's borderline so bad it's good. It's fun. It's sort of fun to watch in the sense that you can just take your brain out and just watch it. And it does drag in some places, but there's enough stupidity, not in how it's written, but just in the general filmmaking itself. It is just utter stupid. It's sort of one of those films that if you're not feeling too well, if you're not feeling in the mood, you can just sit back and watch and take your mind off things for a bit. And it's for that reason that I have to give it 4 out of 10. No more than 4, no less than 4. I.e., it definitely doesn't deserve any more than 4, but to be honest, it's not bad enough to warrant it getting less than 4. So, this is the end of the video, and thank you for watching. If you liked what you see, give that subscribe and like button a little tickle, and I'll be seeing you next time. See you later.